This last year, we have tested a bunch of different solar panel stands here at the lab, and today we're going to rank them from our most to least favorite. And hopefully we can help you guys spend your hard-earned money on the product that is best for you, so you don't end up with some stupid gadget like the EcoFlow solar tracker. Nobody needs that. So welcome back to the lab, where our opinions cannot be bought. In 2025, price is more important than ever. It seems like every day you wake up and the cost of living has gone up by another $10, but price isn't the only thing to consider when you're looking for a solution to mount your solar panels. As always, we have links to all the products that we will talk about in today's video in the description below, as well as any coupon codes that we can get for you guys to help you save any money wherever possible. But let's jump right into it and start from the bottom. In dead last, we have the Amazon Special Eco-Worthy Ground Mount. When we originally purchased this thing, it was only $100 on Amazon. It was actually $118 and it had a $20 off coupon, but that made it a really good deal. The price of them has since increased to $139, which is actually $169 with a now $30 coupon. But still, for the price, you get a decent system. That higher price though has fixed one of the major issues that we had with the unit, which would have been the sag. First thing that this did when we set it up was sag in the middle because it only had two legs, one on either end, and there was no third leg. And ours has just sagged worse and worse over time. Over last winter, the sag got a lot more exaggerated. But like I said, for that $139, they now include a middle leg, which is supposed to help avoid your unit sagging at all. But even though they've made a little bit of innovation, this thing is in dead last because the materials are cheap. You can grab almost any piece of this ground mount and just twist it like this with your bare hands. The metals are not super strong. And if they are not secured properly, like everything is perfectly secured down, they will buckle underneath any sort of storm. And what I mean by that is we had one that was not perfectly secured to the ground. And when a storm came through, the legs all shifted and bent and the panel slid over on top. The whole thing completely destroyed itself because the metals are just not strong enough to take the slightest little bit of abuse. It's okay, and for the price, I can't argue if it's something that you want, but it is flimsy when compared to other options on the market. You do have pretty limited panel sizes that will actually fit onto a stand like this. We can't get anything more than like a 250 on there and get four across. As soon as you put anything as big as like a 400, you can only do two. And it definitely has a shorter life expectancy than some of the other ones on the list. If we're talking about permanent panel solutions, the power racks are going to come in fourth place. The cool thing about the power racks is that they're basically the only ones that could also be temporary. You can easily stack them in the back of a truck, bring them to a site, set them up temporarily by just throwing like sandbags or something in them to give them weight, run it for however long your event is, and then easily stack them all up, pack them back away in your truck, and take them back with you. Right now, they're only about $75 on Signature Solar's website, which does make them the cheapest option that we're going to talk about today. But there is some issues that we have with the power racks, the biggest one being that it only works with a very limited size of solar panel. We actually didn't have a panel here at the lab that properly actually bolted onto the power rack system because it doesn't just work with, you know, a 100 to 400 range. It works with a very specific size range. So you would have to very meticulously plan out your kit with the power racks and with the panels you want to use with them. You can't just go on Signature Solar's website, find your favorite solar panel and buy a pallet of them. It probably won't actually fit the power rack. So that was a huge problem. A few other pain points that we had with these was they're only held down by plastic clips. While yes, that is secure, I guess. Every other solar panel mount that we have, you bolt down a nut and bolt fastener to hold that panel to the stand. These ones, you just kind of put a plastic clip on them and hope that that plastic clip doesn't break in the cold or the heat, and that it's strong enough to hold it with any sort of storm or natural disaster that you might get in your area. And the other thing is that the price does not reflect the finished product. You still need to fill those bins, and assuming that you're not excavating a house at the time of you setting up your solar array, you're gonna have to pay for some sort of fill, whether that's rocks, dirt, gravel, sand, something to go in those. You're also gonna wanna put ground anchors in them. So while it looks like the cheapest option on the market, there is still more cost that goes into actually making it stay put. that you don't necessarily think about when you're just looking at the sales page on a website. They're also pretty low to the ground, which where we live, we get a lot of snow. That would be a huge problem. Like right away, you'd have to really clear in front of those panels all the time so that they could shed snow. It just adds a layer of work that nothing else on this list is that low to the ground. You would never have to deal with it. Overall, in our review video, we even said this, we see why people are buying them. They're very cheap and they're very versatile. But when you put them up against the competition of permanent solar panel ground mounts, they just don't stand up. The Chico Ground Flex is definitely the most industrial, biggest option on this list. It took the team here at the lab a couple of days to set this thing up, but now that it is, and we've been using it for a little while here, we can confirm that it's medium, a perfect third place. The 30 panel stand, which is the one we have, at the time of us filming our video, was $5,100, not including the footings. The footings you can get from Chico, or you could do what we did and we got our own footings, but that's still an additional fee on top of the $5,100. There is a 10 panel stand option that's about half the price. So this system is definitely an investment, but it's also a great way to get a shitload of panels in a very small area. Well, I shouldn't say a small area, but it's a good way to get a ton of panels in a tighter formation than you would with any other option on this list. Overall, we were happy with the Chico Ground Flex. It feels very strong. It's scalable if you want to start with a smaller kit and then add on. We actually left an entire footing off of ours when we built it, so technically it's not 30 panels, it's like 26, because it would have gone into the neighbor's yard because it's a very big system. But you can easily just buy a 10 panel mount now and then another 10 later and they bolt right together. There's nothing you have to do to adapt them. They just work. So being easily scalable is a huge pro, and you can easily fit a wide variety of solar panels on this thing. If you're looking for a way to get a lot of solar in a small space, these drone shots that you're looking at are 415 watt panels, which look big on other ground mounts. This makes them look absolutely tiny. Like you could easily get massive panels on this Chico Ground Flex. We just don't yet because those are the panels that we happen to be testing right now. But this setup overall is permanent. It's pretty legit, but there was still some pain points with it. The first place it fell short was the install was a mega pain in the ass. Basically, the instructions they give you are not very clearly labeled. So if you're not really familiar with building, you can get confused very, very easily. We are familiar with building, and it was still a complicated process. There was issues like the diagram showing pieces with certain holes drilled in them that we didn't get. Ours didn't have those holes drilled in them, so we weren't sure which way things had to be assembled. So you basically had to assemble it, try it, and if it didn't work, switch them the other way around and then do it, which unfortunately we basically did for every single run of legs. There's also a hardware shortage. We didn't get all the hardware we needed. We had to make multiple trips to the store to get nuts and bolts to complete the setup. And the hardware that you're supposed to use isn't clearly labeled. Like it never says use the M8x30 bolt. It just shows a bolt going in a hole and you have to kind of guesstimate what nut and what bolt combo actually goes in there. So there is a lot of guessing that has to go into the setup of this system with trips to the hardware store. And at the end of the day, if you're doing something DIY, you don't want the DIY portion of what you're doing to make you reconsider being alive. I hope I can say that on YouTube. Aside from the install being a disaster, the galvanized dip on a lot of the parts was very chunky. We actually did buy the footings from them, and you're supposed to drive these ground pilings in, but the tubes they give you to go through the footing don't fit. The tubes are over galvanized and the inside of the footing is over galvanized. There's literally chunks of galvanized dip in there. So you would have to spend time sanding everything down, cleaning everything out. That's not something you should have to be doing, especially at the price range of this system. We actually opted for our own screw-in pilings because it was way easier, way faster. And at the end of the day, it's just gonna work better. And the last real holdup with this is the price. It's f***ing expensive, period. At the time of us getting our original EG4 Bright Mount, it was about $250 with our discount code. It has come and go off Signature Solar's website since then. We've seen waves of comments saying it's not available and then another waves of people saying that they've got one. They say that they're currently working on a new version that is going to be replacing the old one and that it is going to be out very soon. So that's probably what's happening here. But when it has come back, the price looks to have gone up and be about $359 right now. The Bright Mount is very light. It's made of all aluminum and it is very strong. Unlike the original mount that I was talking about, where you can just pick it up and twist it from EcoWorthy, this one is very, very strong, thick aluminum, and I was honestly really impressed with the quality of it for the price. I also built the entire thing in under an hour, including going to the store to get an iced coffee. It was a very simple setup, and it was overall very DIY friendly. The instructions and everything were good enough that you could just rip through it, no problem. We like that it's adjustable. There's little bolts on there that you can go in and unscrew and adjust to the height of it without making the adjustable component of it kind of like flimsy. It's very solid, but you still can adjust it for different angles in the winter or the summer. It's properly grounded. It came with a ground screw that you can drive right into the earth and actually properly ground your system, which is rare. A lot of these companies aren't sending us ground screws. Even Chico, with their $5,000 mount, never sent us a like proper grounding spike or anything with that kit. The Bright mount also has a ton of support legs. There's absolutely no sag. We have had ours go through an entire winter. We've had it be somewhat secured to the ground and have a massive windstorm come through and toss it across the yard. It never bent, it never broke. It's literally completely straight still. The wood base that we had on at one point is a little fragile at this point, but like the actual mounts, all the metals are completely fine. But even this one wasn't perfect. And some of the gripes that we had with it was the manual wasn't beginner friendly. For someone that knows what they're looking at, very clear, it was pretty easy to follow, but it mentions a bolt being M8 by 70. If you've never done this before, you don't build things frequently, you might not know what that is. It'd be much better if they just labeled everything, considering how easy it was to build, like IKEA, and they gave everything a number or a letter or whatever, said that's the bolts you need, use them. It didn't come with enough mid clamps to run all the panels that you actually see us running, which was weird because we couldn't fit four 415 Sirius panels across. It was too wide. But when we tried to put our I think they're 200 or maybe they're 220 or something weird, panels across, there wasn't enough mid clamps to actually mount all those panels all the way across. We had to steal some from another panel stand that we weren't using at the time. So more of those would be very nice. And the last thing is that it only has a single footing to mount it to the ground, meaning it has to be mounted to something very, very solid, like a concrete pad, or you're gonna have to pour some sono tubes or something to mount it to. A lot of these other ones with a front and back foot, you can find ways to mount those where they're still gonna do pretty solid because they're level. But this, all the weight comes down and teeters off one point. So you really have to put a lot of time and thought into that one point to make sure that you don't buckle your system under high winds or snow. It does make the final install process just a tiny bit harder, but not so bad that we didn't still put it in second place. The Integra Rack is possibly the most versatile, simplest solar panel mount on the market. It is lightweight, it's made from all aluminum with some stainless steel components, and it's capable of supporting any solar panel size. They claim up to 800. We had a massive 570 on this thing, and it still had room to go. And right now, you can get this thing for $119 per leg, and our discount code actually makes it even slightly cheaper. So something like this isn't much more expensive than the Power Rack, and it's a way better option in our opinion. The system assembles in literal minutes. You have a bottom runner and two uprights, you drop the uprights in and put bolts through them, tighten them, and you're done. It works with any panel size. Any meaning it'll go up really, really high. It doesn't work with obviously tiny ones. We only had one panel here at the lab that didn't fit it, and it was just too short to reach from the top to the bottom. It was like a 100 watt panel. Otherwise, there was not a single panel we had here that could not fit on it. That leads into kind of the mounting options. It's because there is no set footing. So you could actually have one 400 watt panel right here, and then the next footings, you could put a 570 because the footings aren't a set space apart. They could be far, they could be close. You could have one of every size solar panel you own on these things and have all the footings close and far apart. All you gotta do is drop in these little anchors and snug it up, and then the footing will adjust to where it needs to be, and you just figure out how you wanna anchor that in the ground. We also really like those little adjustable anchors that it comes with. You're actually able to slide the panel all the way up or all the way down on the mount, so you could make more ground room or slide it way closer to the ground if for whatever reason that's what you wanna do. You can get additional adjustable arms for this setup if that's something you want. They just bolt right on and you can tilt them up or down depending on the time of year. They're extremely lightweight and they come in a really small box, which will be perfect to get them to some sort of off-grid site. Very easy, you could throw them on an ATV and take them down a trail. much easier than we did when we took the Chico ground mount on an ATV down a trail. And overall, it's just a really clean system. It's probably, in our opinion, the best looking system we have here at the lab, hands down. And for the fact that it's also one of the cheapest, like, how do you go wrong? The only thing that we didn't like about this entire setup was the grounding spikes. They want you to pre-drill a hole, put the grounding spike in, and then pour like an epoxy in it, and it kind of like oozes out of the bottom, creates like a really permanent anchor. We don't want it permanently anchored where we have them. We want to be able to move it or whatever. So we didn't want to pre-drill it and fill it with epoxy. And when you just hammer it into the ground, they bend right to shit. Like they're not solid enough to be driven in the ground. They need that pre-drilled hole, which was kind of annoying. We actually had to cut the tips off ours just so we could fire them in the ground to hold it down. But aside from that, which again is honestly a smaller thing because a lot of people probably won't use them, a lot of people probably do their own thing, or they will leave them permanently. They won't do what we do where we need to move things all the time. It's not a bad setup. At the end of the day, this one is cheap. It looks amazing. You can run almost any size solar panel that you want, and there's no rules when it comes to the system. So if any of our friends, which includes you guys, you're our friends, asked us what solar panel ground mount you should be buying right now, we would recommend to you and our friends to go ahead with the Integra Rack IR30s right now. They're probably our favorite ones on the market. Anyways, let us know if there's any other solar panel ground mounts that you guys want us to review on the channel. Like I said earlier, we will leave links to the products we talked about in the description down below, as well as coupon codes for you guys to help you save some money where we can. Otherwise, make sure you guys are subscribed if you're not already. We will catch you next time. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.